Every year the market offers smartphones of all kinds, with different names and different potentials but which essentially support the same operating system, Android, which is the true master of the world market. Although its diffusion has encouraged the spread of Linux, its philosophy stands out in many respects from what is the concept of open source. On the internet we find dozens of custom ROMs with different features and functionalities, often not easy to install due to the bootloader block. Often the use of an Android terminal requires registration to Google services, with all the advantages that Big G offers to its users, but at the expense of privacy. Suffice it to say that browsing the internet or doing research of any kind we often find suggestions for topics similar to those we have looked for. These are market surveys, and without a doubt companies benefit from this data collected by users in their everyday life. Often and unwillingly we find ourselves having to press with a finger on pop-ups and banners by mistake or install hidden services that squeeze the hardware resources of our devices. A user who only wants to use a device to call and send messages, until a few years ago had no great alternative in choosing between a smartphone and a simple feature phone. KaiOS has come to meet many users who wanted a safe alternative, that offered simplicity but without too many sacrifices. KaiOS is the son of Firefox OS, a smartphone operating system that was based on privacy and easy accessibility for developers because the software is open source. Privacy and open source are not words that companies and major investors like for avant-garde applications and utilities in step with the times. This is the real reason that decreed the death of Firefox OS. Its revival, which took place with the development of KaiOS, was possible thanks to certain compromises. 1. Make devices available at more affordable prices in emerging markets such as Africa and India. 2. Spread the software on non-touch devices, then take advantage of its lightness on feature phones using very low hardware requirements. 3. Take advantage of the latest generation networks to spread the pre-installed services of the main partners, such as Google, in areas of the planet where the internet was a luxury for the few. In this way KaiOS has succeeded in flattening the digital division, and will continue to do so in the coming years. However, the spread of an emerging operating system with solid open source bases has attracted curiosity and enriched the hopes of those who really hoped for a freer alternative to the mobile telephony market, monopolized by the giants Android and iOS. Not everyone wants a smartphone. Not everyone wants to fill their pockets with large, delicate devices, more like portable televisions that run invisible and inaccessible services in the background, for the average user who didn't want to feel cut off from the world. KaiOS has all the potential to be the alternative to smartphones, but these potentials are exploitable to the maximum only through a thorough research. This research is temporarily limited by the blocks of many manufacturers, which have the exclusivity on the products they sell to the end user. Many of these end users are represented by our community, Bonanna Hackers. I personally, until the summer of 2018, when I bought my Nokia 8110 4G, I didn't have enough knowledge to be convinced that I had purchased the right phone. I had purchased this product because my only needs were 1. Calling people and send SMS. 2. Listening music with a player who divides the songs between artists and albums, for an easy search for the song I wanted. KaiOS gave me this opportunity, but at the time it had very poor software, lacking in good smartphone functionality, unlike how it was presented by its reviewers, and with slow and still too primitive software to compete with Android, despite good intentions. Personally, I felt cheated, seeing the Nokia 8110 only as a market strategy to entice people to buy a smartphone. The nostalgia effect seemed to have vanished without even beginning. But one day I found this forum, comp.mobile.nokia.8110, called Bonanna Hackers, whose founder, Lux4, had illustrated a method to install applications on that device I was regretting having purchased. I was the 13th member of this community. I was waiting every day for news from the few subscribers, and I was watching what was being published to try to install applications that I needed. 1. A file manager, to put the songs in order. 2. A reader of PDF or documents in general, to consult the bus timetables. No interesting answers. So I decided to use my skills as a researcher on the internet to contribute in my own small way to the research, for the few fans present on the forum. By publishing the link to the discontinued Firefox OS marketplace containing over 4,000 applications, I actively began contributing to the research, but without the necessary basic knowledge for developing applications in JavaScript, HTML and CSS. It took almost 2 months to figure out which packet format was accepted by OmniSD, and then to insert a pointer in applications that required touch input, as the applications were all for Firefox OS smartphones. I then started distributing a few dozen of applications, and then added some web wrappers that increased that subspecies of story that I called BHackers Store to over 120 unofficial ports. Seeing my commitment, Luxfer appointed me as a forum administrator, although I still considered myself, and I still consider myself today, below the potential of many forum members. You know well the rest of this story. Today we have a Google site of technical guides and tutorials on KaiOS, a store of applications that can be installed via OmniSD, a YouTube channel that produces sufficiently useful guides for the less experienced, if not even for beginners who are approaching for the first time to command line. I hope to be able to continue with this research alongside the other banana hackers, even though many assumptions that I indicated at the beginning of the video let me think that this world we created from nothing could end at any moment. With this video I just wanted to share how a banana hacker was born from nothing. Like many others I started without knowledge, exploiting only the passion for alternative platforms, for Linux and for Team Spirit, which was useful and continues to be useful for many new users who buy a KaiOS device, which today is not very different from an Android, if you go to analyze the Linux base of each of them. The objectives are many and the desire to involve people passionately in this world is even greater. I hope you will continue to be numerous people over the years and to support our principles and our desire to change the world through technology, whatever may be the fate of the banana hackers community. Thank you for your attention and your cooperation. See you next. BananaHackers.net. We are revolution.